Hi guys, I'm Erica. Welcome to Hack Your Health. In today's video, I'm going to talk about the benefits and sources of iodine. So we need iodine in order to make thyroid hormone, and the thyroid is in your neck, and what it does is it takes iodine and uses it to make thyroid hormone, which basically regulates your metabolism. It helps regulate things like your menstrual cycle and your hormones, and basically every cell in your body needs thyroid hormone. And in order to make it, your body needs iodine. So sometimes low thyroid or hypothyroidism can be the result of simply not having enough iodine for your body to make that hormone. And iodine deficiency can result in things like cold hands and feet, menstrual issues and breast pain, as well as metabolic issues like weight gain and infertility, and goiter, which is a lump in your throat, which is basically the swollen thyroid, and many other issues. So it's very important to get enough iodine in your diet. Essentially, iodine comes from the ocean. So any crop that's grown on land, the iodine content will really vary depending on location. That's why historically some places have been called goiter belts, because there isn't enough iodine in the soil to provide enough to prevent a goiter, and more people in those areas would have goiters. And closer to the ocean, where there's access to seafood as well as more iodine in the soil, goiters were definitely less common. However, today when people are generally not eating local foods, iodine deficiency can really happen anywhere. And it may seem strange that humans, which are not a sea creature, need iodine, but if you think about the fact that human beings gradually evolved from animals which lived in the ocean, it starts to make more sense. Humans who were living a hunter-gatherer lifestyle would travel very long distances to get access to seafood, and they would also trade for seaweed from tribes that live closer to the ocean. So humans have always put a lot of effort into getting seafood and iodine. So the best sources of iodine are seafood, such as scallops, prawns, oysters, and non-fatty fish is also higher in iodine than fatty fish. And freshwater fish has some iodine, but it's much less than ocean fish. So basically, if you eat a lot of seafood, you don't have much to worry about in terms of iodine deficiency. Seaweed is also a very good source of iodine, and the iodine level of seaweed really depends on how it's grown, what part of the ocean it's grown in, whether it's wild or cultivated, etc. And if you'd like a whole video about the iodine content of seaweed, let me know, because that's a very big topic that I don't have enough time for in this video. But for sure, seaweed is a great source of iodine, and if you're on a vegan or a vegetarian diet, that's probably your best source. In the description box, I'll include a link to a list of the iodine content of different foods, including seafoods, so you can get a better idea of how much iodine each of those foods contains. Another great way to get iodine that traditional cultures use is to make a fish stock, and you can put the fish heads and the fish carcass in there, and it doesn't need to be boiled for as long as bone broth. Can just be for a couple of hours, and that creates a very iodine-rich broth, and I'll make a video about that in the future. Fish eggs are another very good source of iodine, and these seafoods also tend to be very high in omega-3, and they can be high in vitamin D as well. So you're not only getting iodine, but a bunch of other nutrients, and things like oysters are also very high in things like copper and zinc and other minerals. So it's very good to get your iodine from a whole food source if you can, because it usually comes along with a lot of other essential nutrients that we also need in small amounts, but that are necessary for our bodies to work properly. However, you can also use something like Lugol's iodine, which is drops. And what I do is I put it on the skin, because that way your body will only absorb the amount that you need. So I'll put those drops in the description box in case you're interested in taking a supplement, but I'm going to focus more on how to get iodine from whole foods in this video. Iodine is very necessary for reproductive health and for the growth and development of infants, both in the womb and after they're born. So iodine was often used, or iodine-rich foods, I should say, were often used to increase fertility in traditional cultures. And today it's also recommended for people who are experiencing infertility to get their iodine levels checked, because low iodine can be a cause of infertility, among many other things. So iodine is necessary for the growth of cells and the proper development of a fetus and our bodies in general. And it's also necessary for healthy brain development in a child. So when mothers are deficient in iodine, the IQ of their child is on average 10 to 15% lower. So it makes a significant difference to the mental development of an infant that their mother has enough iodine. It's very important during pregnancy and breastfeeding, and iodine needs double during those times. So it makes sense that other sources of iodine-rich foods are dairy products and eggs, because like us, baby animals also need iodine for their growth and development. So dairy is another very rich source of iodine, such as milk, cheese, yogurt, etc. And in grass-fed dairy, the proximity to the ocean that the animals are living in affects the iodine levels quite a bit. So in coastal climates, the dairy will be richer in iodine than in inland areas, but there will be some iodine present in all dairy products. And when it comes to conventional dairy, the animals are actually supplemented with iodine. So it's not exactly the same form of iodine that you would find in grass-fed dairy, but your body can still use it, and it's still important to get iodine, and that's a source. So the reason why they supplement dairy cattle with iodine is because basically they, like us, need it to be healthy and they need it to produce good milk. And the feed that dairy cattle are being fed is canola and soy based. So when they make canola oil, they basically extract the oil from the seeds and then they're left with the solid part of the seeds. And that is used to feed dairy cattle. And same thing with soy. So these are goitrogenic foods, especially canola. So what that means is that it actually blocks the absorption of iodine, and it prevents the thyroid gland from being able to use the iodine in order to make thyroid hormone. So if you eat, or if animals eat goitrogenic foods, their needs for iodine increase because the body isn't able to use it as well as if those goitrogenic foods weren't present in the diet. So eating the canola and soy feed actually increases the animal's need for iodine, and that's one of the reasons why it's supplemented. They also use iodine to clean the udders of the cows when they milk them. So they dip them in an iodine solution because iodine is a disinfectant, and that gets absorbed through the skin. So that's another way that those cows are getting iodine. It's not necessarily all from their diet. Some of it's from that cleansing solution as well. But regardless, either way, they still pass that through their milk, because naturally animals will provide iodine to their young because it's necessary for growth and development. So there will always be iodine present in milk products, just to varying degrees based on their diet and where they're living and other factors like that. Eggs are another great source of iodine, particularly the egg yolks, and that can also be quite varying depending on their feed, but since iodine is necessary for the growth and development of the chick, there will always be iodine present in the egg as well, so that's another really good source. Another really great source of iodine is liver and other organ meats. So your glands and your organs in your body all store iodine, and it's the same for animals. Because these need iodine in order to function properly, there's a higher concentration in the organs and the glands. So when you eat organ meats like liver and kidneys, for example, you are getting more iodine. In muscle meat, there's almost no iodine, so it's not a very reliable source. So in order to get iodine from animal foods that aren't from the ocean, it's best to eat the organ meats. So in my case, I usually eat quite a bit of seafood, and I eat yogurt every day, as well as eggs. And lately I've started incorporating some seaweed into my diet as well, and that's basically what I'm doing to cover the bases in terms of iodine. And that's that might be some ways that you could get iodine into your diet as well. If you grow your own food and you're concerned about the iodine content of the soil where you live, you can also use seaweed to increase the iodine content of the soil. So I live very close to the ocean, and I remember my grandmother doing this. We would go down to the beach and get a bunch of seaweed, and that would be to put in the garden. And if you want to increase the calcium content as well, you could also grab some oyster shells. That's also very good for gardening. So that's my suggestion if you're growing your own food and you want to increase the iodine content of your fruits and vegetables that you're growing. But I understand that that's only really accessible if you live close to the ocean, so there's probably also some kelp-based or seaweed-based fertilizer available that would probably also be helpful for that. And another issue when it comes to iodine deficiency is goitrogenic foods, which I kind of touched on when it comes to cattle feed. Just like those animals, when we eat goitrogenic foods, we can also become deficient in iodine or just not be able to use the iodine that we do get into our diets properly. So that includes things like unprocessed soy and canola, and it also includes kale, broccoli, cabbage, and those cruciferous vegetables, as well as fruits with pits like plums and even almonds and peaches, etc., and cherries. So those are just a few of the goitrogenic foods that if you eat along with iodine can affect its absorption or at least its use by the thyroid gland and can lead to hypothyroidism in that way. So one important thing that you can do to reduce the goitrogens in your food is cook them. So for example, if you cook cabbage, it reduces the goitrogens by 90%. So that's when you cook it for 30 minutes. So if you cook these vegetables, that effect is largely reduced. And I think that part of the reason why vegans are very commonly deficient in iodine, which they are, and I'll link a study below if you'd like to do more research into that, is because they're eating these goitrogenic foods probably with every meal, as well as excluding many of the iodine-rich foods from their diet. So this is something to keep in mind if you're eating a lot of cruciferous vegetables, especially if you're eating them raw. That might actually increase your needs for iodine and affect its use in your body. My personal recommendation would be to eat those foods cooked, and it's also easier for you to digest them when they're cooked, and probably easier to access the nutrients in them as well. And of course, those goitrogenic foods get their name from the word goiter and the suffix gen. So gen, if you think of the word generation or genesis or other words that start with G-E-N, it means creation or creating. So goitrogens means goiter creating foods, which means that they would create that lump due to low iodine and hypothyroidism. So that's how those foods got their name, and that's something to think about when you're eating those kinds of foods if you're at risk for an iodine deficiency. As well, there's many medications, prescription ones, that are also goitrogenic. So if you're on several different very common drugs, you can also have an increased need for iodine as a result of that. So if you're having issue with iodine deficiency or hypothyroidism, it might be a good idea to ask your doctor about, if you're on any medication, whether those are goitrogenic medications, and he or she might be able to help you increase your iodine levels. So as always, this is not medical advice. This is based on my personal research, and it's where I intention to help you with your research. So I'll also put the references for this information in the description box below so you can continue with your research if you're interested. And if you have any questions about what I covered in this video, please let me know, and I really hope that this is helpful to you. And if you'd like future videos about iodine, more in depth about the benefits or how it's used in the body or the thyroid itself, etc., let me know, because I'm happy to do more research and create videos on those topics if that would be useful to you. And thank you so much for watching. And if you like this video, please press like to let me know. And if you're interested in more of my videos, then you can always subscribe to my channel, and that way you'll get notified when I make a new video. And if you're interested in my foods for vitamin D or foods for healing Crohn's disease and specific carbohydrate and diet and those topics, I have a lot of those videos already on my channel in case you're interested. And thank you for watching and all the best on your healing journey. Okay, bye.